Experience for all of us. Welcome to Durban 2014.
To watch Indians dance is to hear our hearts speak. The Indian dance embraces a rich assortment of color, motion, and rhythm. They have the ability to create an image of variation with a blast of colors that come together to perfectly define what we call unity in diversity. From the likes of Sarojini Naidu to the beauty of Rukmini Devi, the most astounding fact that baffles us today is that their legacies are being carried down by the very performers you will see today. These dances and dancers carry with them our strongest asset, our culture and heritage. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Indian Group Classical and Theme Dance Event of Durban 2014.
Dance is a symbol of communication which brings out the innermost feelings. It depicts the most sacred cultural aspects of a civilization. Indian dance is believed to be a form of worship through which a dancer is said to communicate with the gods. Today, Indian dance forms have captured global attention in all cultural vistas of the world. This afternoon, different performers from across the university will set out to beat the best in order to be the best. We have with us an eminent panel of judges. Our first judge is Mrs. A. Geeta Gopinath. A. Geeta Gopinath is a postgraduate diploma holder from one of the most renowned prestigious dance institutions, Kalakshetra in Chennai. She is one of the few students who had the privilege to be a student of Srimati Rukmini Devi Arundel in Bharatanatyam. She is a CCRT scholarship holder given by the Ministry of Culture for Advanced Training in Bharatanatyam. She has been part of many dance productions by the Kalakshetra team and has also played many lead roles like Sita and Meenakshi in the production. She has traveled to various cities in Russia, China, USA, UK, and Norway to perform and to train many young dancers. She is an Adil Peroli title awardee by Adi Parashakti Temple, USA. She has served as a dance teacher for more than 15 years in Kerala and Chennai and was also heading the dance department at Kale Kaveri College of Fine Arts, Trichy for four years. Currently, she is running a dance institution in Chennai named Rukmini Kshetram that trains students in Bharatanatyam and Natuvangam. Welcome, ma'am.
Our next judge for today is Ms. Ranita Mukherjee. She is a graduate from Arta Kalari's diploma in movement arts and mixed media. She has been trained in Bharatanatyam for more than 20 years. She is also trained in Kalariparayattu, classical ballet, contact improvisation, and other contemporary dance techniques. She has also explored other art forms like jazz, Pilates, and Kathak. She is currently working as a senior dancer, instructor, and choreographer at Arta Kalari Bangalore. She was a part of major Arta Kalari productions, namely For Peena and Medhwani. She is an integral part of Arta Kalari's education outreach program. She leads classes in contemporary dance for kids as well as adults at the institution. She has conducted many workshops and lecture demonstrations to dancers in various cities in India and abroad. She has been an integral part for various dance productions like For You a Thousand Times Over, I See Dreams in Grey, and Body Without Brain. We welcome you, ma'am.
Our final judge for the day is Mrs. Poovarasi Nagarajan. She started learning dance at an age of 11 under Guru Srimati Akhila Satyanarayanan. She has completed her bachelor's and master's in Bharatanatyam. She is also an MPhil holder in Bharatanatyam from Madras University. She has also been trained in contemporary dance. She commenced her career as a tutor and performer in NBCLC Bangalore. She has participated in various prestigious art festivals such as Women's Day Program, Natyanjali held at Chidambaram, Indian Arts Festival held at European countries and so on. She started her dance school, Sai Swastik Natyalaya in 2008 at Chennai to encourage young budding dancers. Besides this, she executes choreography for various external cultural activities and has performed in various stage shows. She is not only a dancer, but also an excellent dubbing artist, performed in one of the prominent TV and FM stations. She pulls out all the stops to get the art reaching every heart. We welcome you, ma'am.
We now begin with the Indian group classical dance event. The rules for the event are: a maximum of 10 members and a minimum of 5 members per team is permitted. No live music is allowed. Only authentic Indian classical songs to be selected. Only one song is allowed, and the time limit is 8 + 1 minute on stage. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first team on stage, Yatna.
And his Bal Leelas. One of the most famous is the Kaliya Nartana. As the story goes, once there lived a 1,000-hooded poisonous snake called Kaliya in the Yamuna River in Vrindavan. One fine day, Krishna and his cowherd friends were playing along the banks of the river and accidentally the ball fell into it. Krishna, on the request of his friends, jumped after it. And then from the water rose up the Kaliya with his 1,000 hoods. Angry, vomiting poison, and he wrapped himself around Krishna's body. Krishna, with all his might, released himself and sprang onto Kaliya's head, assuming the weight of the whole universe, started dancing on his head, stamping his feet. Kaliya, thus recognizing the greatness of Lord, surrendered, and Krishna, pardoning him, let him go free. We, Team Yatna, present this very episode today. Ladies and gentlemen, the Kaliya Nartana Kirtanam in Ragam Punagavarali and Talam Adi.
Oh,
Yasna, we next have on stage Supreme Kalarka
and devotion, of utter spiritual surrender and courage, a representation of our inner child. The complete surrender of Hanuman towards Maryada Purushottam Sri Ram is strung beautifully into one of the most complicated pieces of Bharatanatyam, a Varnam. This Varnam, composed by Madurai R. Muralidharan, set to Talam Adi in the Raga Keeravani, is a piece that brings out the playful